Every day, thousands of innocent people are infected by the deadly 404 virus. Once infected, they endlessly scour the web to find the promised land, the right links. And when they don't find what they're looking for, they transform into links.
All right, jokes apart. In this video, we're actually going to learn how to prevent and fix 404 errors on your WordPress website, specifically broken links on your WordPress website, using the power of a brand new SEO plugin, which is called Broken Link Checker by One SEO. It's technically not an SEO plugin, but it does offer some feature which help in SEO. That's why I said SEO plugin. And it's made by the fantastic team at One SEO that make the fantastic SEO plugin, One SEO or AIOSEO for short. Before I actually get into the demonstration, I have to address one important question that you might be thinking of already. You might be thinking, hey, Yuvraj, I already know 50 different plugins that can do the same functionality. If I go into the WordPress repository, I search for Broken Link Checker, I'll find 50 different plugins that offer the same functionality. And in fact, inside All-in-One SEO, there's a feature called 404 Monitor that technically does the same thing. So is this new plugin different from the SEO plugins that I've been mentioning? Or is this plugin different from the functionality inside All-in-One SEO, the SEO plugin already? Yes, it is, and it's not. I have to explain so that you can understand why this plugin is much more powerful, much more scalable, and much more effective in finding and fixing broken links on your site, and why you should install it and consider it at least to have it on your website. So the big difference between this plugin and the other plugins is that this plugin does not add the functionality to check the broken links on your website. Instead of adding the functionality to your website, it actually uses an external service which is created, maintained, and hosted by All-in-One SEO, where all the link checks happen. And the second thing why this plugin is different from the other plugins is that this plugin also has a service where you can check for external broken links. Now, this feature is already very unique, but let's say if you were to find a plugin that did this on your website, then your hosting providers will usually not like it because they don't like your server pinging external services to check for broken links. The second important difference to realize between this new plugin and all the other 404 checkers out there is that most 404 error checkers are reactive, not proactive, while this plugin is proactive. Let me explain the difference. So a user doesn't have to click any links on your site for this plugin to find all the broken links on your website. That means you're providing the best user experience by proactively fixing all the broken links, and you're saving money in the process because any kind of link clicks that make you money, if they're broken, you're losing money in the process. So that's the second difference. Let me also talk about the third important technical difference. So a couple of things you should know about before you decide if you want to use this plugin on your website. First of all, this is a freemium service. It's not a standalone plugin. It's a freemium service. That means you'll have a free quota that you can utilize. And this free quota is not something that you get for life. What it means is that it renews every month. So whatever free quota you have, you'll get a reset every single month. So you'll have that quota that you can utilize every single month. The second important thing to realize is that external links checking that I mentioned is part of only the paid plan. So in the freemium version, you don't get that feature. So if you think that external link checking is a valuable feature for you, you can check out the pricing plan. I'll leave a link down in the description of this video. So I hope you understood all those points and also the important technical differences I explained on why this plugin is different and, in my opinion, much better than a regular 404 monitor. And by now, you should have a decent idea in your head that if this plugin can be useful for your website. So what I recommend is that watch this video or the demonstration now and then check out the links in the description for the pricing options. You can go in out or just install the free version right now and start using the plugin. All right, let's do the demonstration on how this plugin will help you or how this plugin's interface is and how you can utilize it and how you can use the features. All right, let's get started with that. So I'm logged into my website now and let me demonstrate how the plugin works. I already have installed the plugin. I already have connected my All-in-One SEO account. I've already connected a payment method. So everything that I was mentioning that you need to do, I already have it done. Once you install the plugin from the WordPress repository, you can go into plugins, add new, find the plugin. You'll be prompted to do all of these things already. So you won't have to figure out how to do it. You'll be prompted to create an All-in-One SEO account or connect to your existing account and also connect the payment method. PayPal is also supported. Once you've done all that, you'll have the broken links menu entry appear here. You can go inside the broken links option here and you'll be presented with two options. The broken links, which we'll talk about. There's also settings we can configure. First, you'll see your license key or your account is connected. You'll see the quota and everything else. But there's some settings you can configure to make sure that the plugin works how you intend it to work. So first option, or the first set of features you should understand, is the live tweaks. So if you enable the first option inside the live tweaks, that means, or what this will do is, it will add nofollow to all the broken links that it finds. So any broken links on a site, there'll be nofollowed. That means search engines won't follow it. That means all the link juice that you have on your site, it won't be spread out to broken links. So that's a great thing. And the second option is that if you want to enable this option, or you enable this option, then the metadata of the post will not be updated if you fix the broken link. So let's say if a post was posted a year ago, if you fix a broken link, technically you should have, or the metadata should be updated. But if in some cases you don't want the metadata to be updated, you can enable this option and the metadata will not be updated. Then you have advanced option as well. So if you go into the advanced option, you have two basic settings that you can utilize. The first is that if you want to include all singulars on your site, if you want to include all singulars, just keep this option enabled. But if you want to exclude certain kind of, let's say, landing pages, or let's say your posts, or any kind of, let's say, singular posts or singulars on your site, you can disable this option and you'll see all the singulars that you have available on your site, and you can enable or disable them. So let's say, for example, I don't want posts to be checked, or let's say, example, I don't want pages to be checked for broken links. I'll just disable this option, save my settings. So only posts will be checked, pages will not be checked. Inside the posts also, I can have a specific status of posts to be checked only. So let's say, for example, I only want the published post to be checked for broken links. So I can disable all of them. But let's say I have a team of writers who work for me, and then I also want to check if any kind of draft or scheduled posts are also have, or do also have broken links. In that case, I can do this. I can disable the private one, pending one. In this case, the links that are published or posts that are published, the posts that are in draft status, and also the scheduled posts that are scheduled to go live on a specific date, they all will be checked for broken links. So you can configure everything here. And if you want to, let's say, exclude a certain set of posts, or just one or couple of posts, you can just type the ID or the title or slug here and then add them here. So these posts that you add here will be excluded from the search. So even though you've selected all these options, you can exclude certain posts from the link checking feature. So once you've configured this, make sure to save your settings, and then what will happen is you can start actually figuring out or seeing broken links on your site. Now, just to give you an idea of how it works is the broken link checker checks for your links, or checks the links on your site every 3 days, so approximately twice a week. This is maintained, or this duration is set so that you don't exhaust your quota very quickly, even if you're on the free version. You can see how many quota or how many links I have, or what's the quota I've utilized. And these are all the links on your site or my site that have been checked. You'll notice that I'm using the free version of the plugin right now. That's why the pro version is being prompted to me if I want to check the external links. I already mentioned this. So all of these links that you see here are external links that I can check, and if I have the pro version enabled, then these will also be checked for broken links. Right now, I'll just skip over this and I'll just come to the internal links on my site. So you see there are a couple of links that I'm seeing. This is perfectly, so this link is working perfectly. That means I don't have to touch this, but this link is broken. Just to clarify once more, no user has clicked on this link, but the link has been identified proactively that this is a broken link. Let me tell you what can you do to fix a broken link. First, you can hover over the link area directly and you'll find a few different options. First thing you can do is edit the URL. So if you can obviously see that, hey, I know this is a misspell of a URL, I can just click the edit URL, I can change the anchor text, I can change the link, I can update it, and it will instantly be fixed. Or I can unlink the link itself. So let's say I don't know what this link is, maybe it was an old link, I want to just remove the link entirely, I'll click the link and the link will be removed entirely. I can also force a recheck. So this is also a great feature that to have. So let's say you're updating a certain set of posts, you want the links to be checked proactively, you can recheck the links manually right here. And you could also dismiss this error. So let's say this is an error, but you know that there's a particular reason for this, you're working on something in the background, or the links are to an upcoming post, then you can dismiss the link or dismiss the error here. On the post level, you have a few different options as well. You can edit the post. So if you click this, you'll directly go to the post. I'll just open it in a new tab. You can also view the post. You can go and check out what the post is about just to figure out what the link is, or you can delete the post entirely. I already clicked edit post in a new tab. So this was just open up the block editor for me. I'll just wait for it to load for a second. I'll go back here. So you can edit the post, you can view the post, you can delete the post entirely. I'll just check going through this error. So block editor is now open. So this is what you can do. If you want to see the actual errors here, you can just check the links manually and fix them accordingly, update the links. So this is what you can do. You can also delete the post. I already mentioned that. But one of the most important features in this plugin is by hovering over this I button. And what this will do once you click on it is give you details about when the link or when the broken link was found. So I click on this and you'll see this information here. Think this link has been broken for 3 days, 21 hours, 19 minutes, and 25 seconds. Now, this is a valuable piece of information because, as I said, one of the most important goals for any webmaster is to get users to click on stuff, whether it be in the search results, whether it be, let's say, subscribe to my whatever email list or make a purchase or click on an affiliate link. You're trying to monetize or even click on ads. So any kind of link you have to figure out as soon as possible if the link is broken. So by checking this information, you get a real time idea of, okay, this is the problem is, or this is what is happening. And you can figure out problems in your workflow if you're connecting links or adding links all the time. So this piece of information is very useful. You also have some lot of metadata here. If you are into technical stuff, you can figure out what's going on. You also have the HTTP status code. So it's a 404, is it a 302, move permanently or something like that. You'll see all these details here, including the response headers. So if you're a techie, you'll find all this information helpful. I think this is the most valuable piece of information. So once you find a broken link, you can just do all sorts of operations, edit the URL, unlink it, recheck it, dismiss it, and fix all the broken links proactively on your site. This is the most important part, proactively fixing all those broken links. And once you fix all this, you'll see all these links or all these errors will go away, and you'll all see just green ticks here, and that means everything is good on your site. There are no broken links. All right, so this is simple functionality, a very powerful functionality, but simple to use, which is the best part, right? Powerful functionality, simple to use, best of both worlds. This is how you use the plugin, the broken link checker by One SEO, to find proactively and fix the broken links on your website. If you have any questions, you can leave in the comments. There's links to the free plugin, there are links to the pricing options in the description of this video. Go check it out. And if you have any feedback for this plugin, you can leave that in the comments as well. Make sure to like this video, subscribe to this channel. I'll see you in the next one.